Emergency crews pulled two people from the water in Madison right after athletes hit the water during the half Ironman event Sunday. One died, one was last reported in critical condition. And a week ago, a 59-year-old man died swimming in the Lake Mills Triathlon. I asked an experienced Ironman triathlete if less open water training this year might have played a role.
It's been a really cold year. The lakes have been much colder than they have in the past. Some events are even canceling their swim because of the cold water temps. And that's really prevented a lot of people from getting the practice in that they've needed for these events.
It's unclear if lack of training contributed to the recent triathlon deaths and injury, but doctors say open water swimming can be more taxing than swimming in a pool. They add anyone considering a triathlon, especially men older than 40, should get a physical before training or competing to detect unknown heart problems. Also, during a race, a surge of adrenaline, as well as swimmers bumping, can lead to increased heart rate, panic, and the potential for a heart attack.
What's going through your mind, your body, when you're about to get in the water, the first part of an Ironman?
There's a lot of nerves before the gun goes off. You're certainly anticipating the beginning of the race, and also, how do I defend myself in the water? How do I protect myself and claim my own space?
And Terry, what else can triathletes do to help prevent a tragedy?
Well, swimmers during training can use something called a swim buoy. Some of the athletes have them right here. A woman right behind me has got a yellow swim buoy. That can help keep you afloat in an emergency. And some races are actually now allowing them during the race events, Patrick.
Terry Sater reporting live in Brookfield tonight.